Greetings viewers, Eric the Car Guy here, back again with another Fairmont build video for you. Ooh, well, those of you that have seen the previous video about rebuilding the differential here might have noticed that I did not install the brake lines at that time, and you're thinking to yourself, Eric, you need brakes! Well, we're gonna get to that right now. Here's our old setup, and guess what? It's for drum brakes. We're running disc. We must make changes, but we can use this as kind of a template. With my kit that I got from LMR that had all these parts, we have all the stuff we need with these fancy steel braided lines to go into the system. Starting with this guy here that's gonna mount on the differential, and then we will run the lines from here out to the edges. To these, they are marked left and right, I hope. I'm just gonna say that this is the right. So yes, this will mount to the caliper here, but you can already see an issue. I'm going to have to drill and tap a hole here for a fastener and also drill a hole here for the locator. And then we'll run a steel line from here to the center point on this guy. And we'll do that on both sides. AmberVision installed. These are the things that we're gonna need. This already has a mounting bolt with some locking stuff on it. Awesome, so we can just mount that up. However, I also have here four fittings. These are 3/16 for 3/16 brake line. I think it's also 4.75 millimeter, not real sure. But yeah, we need to be able to, oh, these ends are different. So we need two of these. And we need two of another size that is yet to be determined that I have to go find. For you, it's been a mere blink of an eye. For us, we took a little trip to the parts store and I got some proper fittings. And these are 3/16 by 7/16. The other ones are 3/16 by 3/8, or in this case, 10 millimeter. Either way, they thread together, it all works. So you're gonna need two of these and two of these in order to make this happen. And this is what kills you on these builds. It's these little things like this that you have to run to the store for that cost you time and money that quite literally nickel and dime you to death. I'm gonna start by mounting our central location here. I suppose I should find out what size socket I need for this. Turns out it's 17 millimeter. This car is gonna be sort of an amalgam between standard sizes and metric, weirdly. It's like it was made to be there. Now that I have the central point mounted, I think I'm going to mount the outer points as well. So that way I can just come in and run my lines. It seems really comfortable right there. And as stated, I'm gonna go grab one of the calipers real quick just to see how that looks, because it making contact here doesn't excite me all that much. But if it's something like this, I'm fine with it. But I just wanna make sure that when the caliper is finally mounted on there, that this is a good position. And then I will commit and tap some holes. So one of my calipers, it mounts on the inside like this. Had to go out and get new fasteners also. It'll give me the positioning that I need. Okay, about as near as I can figure, I've got the caliper mounted here on its bracket. This will come in here like this. Mount right there. And that way it'll clear the parking brake assembly and everything else. Here's the dilemma. We need to mount this here, just like this. I'm gonna take a fastener, which is actually this 6x1 fastener, and I'm gonna run it right into here to hold this down. I also need to drill another hole for this locator. I have a 6x1 tap ready to go. Drill bit size is 13/64 for this, and I'm just gonna take my punch and mark where I want this to be, right in the center. Also gonna mark this guy just so that I can get that hole situated. And that one can be right in there. Obviously it's gonna be a much larger hole. And now we drill. Like I said, this is, just wanna confirm, yeah, 13/64 drill bit for this 6x1 tap. And I'll add a little oil so I don't burn my bit up. For those of you concerned about me getting metal shavings inside my freshly rebuilt rear end, it's sealed. All the seals and everything are in it right now. Well, let's tap the hole. This I'm definitely gonna add some oil to. Been told by many viewers to go in a little bit. It just started biting now, and then back it off to help clear out the hole. Yay. Now I need to drill the locator hole, for lack of a better word, so that this tab can rest down in. Now, I don't want to drill the hole too big so that this thing flops around. I want to make it just large enough. And just sizing it up against this drill bit, it looks pretty darn close. So I'm going to eventually get to this, what looks like 25/64 is the size on that drill bit. Anyway, I'm not going to start with this bit. I'm actually going to end with it. I've already made a pilot hole, and I'm going to start with a smaller size before I go up to the larger size, just so that it goes a bit smoother. Usually you don't want to go for the biggest drill bit first. You usually start out with a smaller size and work your way bigger. Doesn't need to be much bigger than that. My original thought for that larger bit may be too large. Seems like I'm really close, so I'm only going up a couple of sizes larger. So close. I need to move over though. So I am gonna need to drill bigger because I'm not quite lined up over here anymore. Jumped up a couple of sizes. Keyless chucks are a blessing and a curse. That might do it. That's not going anywhere. Done. Other side. Process is going to be the same for this side. I'm going to use this to make the mark for this. That way I've got a more accurate mark. Sort of barely did it the last time. So if this is the outside, I want to come inside just a little bit, and I'm going to look for the center, which looks to be about there. On there. Doing final assembly. Want to keep it clean. Here's my old brake line setup. Now that I have my ends, my terminations, both here and here set up, next thing I want to do is run the brake line itself. This is the old brake line. It's roughly the same shape. I'm not intent on reusing it because I got shiny new brake line over there, but it's going to give me a good indication of the shape I need to cut. Also, this ran all the way out to the wheel. I only need to go there. The one thing I'm wrestling with though is this is probably the only retainer that I have. And this being the long brake line side, maybe that means something, but you might hate me for saying this, but I'm thinking zip ties. You know, maybe black ones so that they blend just to hold it tight to the housing. That's it. But for now, I'm going to remove these from the center portion just so that they're easier to manage and I can get an idea of where I'm going to run them. Something tells me I'm going to need something else to hold that. Good thing I got tools around. And this is already cut. It's, aside from maybe this nut that I'll keep just for posterity, useless. All of this looks freaking excellent. In fact, I think I will reuse that bracket, why not? So all of this looks fantastic, except for maybe that little kink there, which I'll fix. But I think if I bring this bend back to here and I do this same little jog there, if I really wanted to and I really had to, I didn't have the brake line, I would reuse this, maybe clean it up. This was meant to be fastened here, but there's no way that's gonna happen with this setup. So I'm not gonna be able to reuse that. I will be able to reuse this, and this being on the long side, okay, no problem. Now this side, same kind of deal. Looks like I'm just gonna start this bend sooner and then do pretty much the exact same thing. Just come up here to 90 and then over there, and we'll be able to mount it up. I've got an idea. Since I have these and I can use these as a template and they're virtually disposable at this point, I think I'm gonna mock them up exactly how I want them to end up being. That way I'll have an exact template to work from when I start with my new lines, and I'll get a chance to practice with these a little bit before we get to the point where we commit. So I'm gonna do precisely that and then cut these to length, everything. I think making my bend about here is a good place to start. One thing I've learned with these forming pliers is you always bend around the pliers. You don't twist the pliers, is I guess what I'm trying to say. I'm just going to take this bend out. It might be a little long. It sort of bunches up back here. But I say, as far as a template, if it's just a little bit shorter, I think it's good. Yeah, I'm super tempted just to reuse that line and just flare the end of it just to save time, but I'll bend a new one, why not? Same drill over here. Terribly exciting. See, it's Eric the car guy, cuts brake line. Nailed it. In fact, it's better on this side than it is on the other side. So cameraman Brian and I were having a discussion off camera, and that is how much time I would save if I just reuse what I have here, which is just about bang on perfect, ready to go. And then I said, well, I want it shiny, I want it pretty. I did a little test with some Brillo pads right here, and it made it shiny and pretty with very little effort. So I'm gonna give that a try. There's nothing wrong with these lines. They're not rusted, they're not. There's a slight kink here in this one from where it got hit somewhere, but gosh darn it, the time that this would save, the time that this would save, invaluable. I still have to flare these lines on the ends here and put the fittings on, which I can put new fittings on. There you go. Outside of that, let's see what these Brillo pads can do. Definitely want to keep debris out of my axle, so I'm gonna keep that in place. Seriously, one little test down here showed me how quickly and easily they clean up. It looks like new. And there wasn't that much effort. So I suppose the question becomes, how much time did I save as compared to how much time I'm spending doing this? But from there out, can you tell this line wasn't new? I'm gonna have to bend this straight in order to flare the end of it, but it's not that big a deal to bend it back into place. I'm okay with this. I won't need this bracket because it's not gonna work. I bet I could hit this with the wire wheel. That would clean that up nice. Yeah, that's the only place that gives me any reservation is right there. Don't worry, I'll run some compressed air through this to make sure there's no debris. That didn't take long at all. And that looks about brand new. I'm gonna wire wheel this end here, bend this straight so that I can flare it, put a new end on it, lock it together. And there it is. You'd almost never know. Not gonna bother with the backside, you'll never see it. It was a little long, so I'm gonna trim it down just a little bit. Tell you what, I know some of you have been screaming at the screen for a while. And you're like, Eric, we don't like that. You're making a performance car. All right, we'll bend a new line for this side. We'll clean up the line for the other side. Fair enough? All right, we'll save half the time. I'm gonna put this vent in permanently. Just mount it in this bracket. That way I don't have to worry about junk or debris getting down in here as I work. And this cap's supposed to be loose like that. You know what though? I'm gonna take just a little bit of Teflon tape, or you know what, better yet, I'm gonna take a little bit of black RTV around the end of those threads before I insert it. That's what I use to seal everything else. That's quite a bit there. Just enough to coat the threads is all I want. That's plenty. Here's my new line. I'm gonna rough it out in the shape. I'm gonna leave this bend here and just leave it straight, and that way I can put that end on, and this end only has a slight bend to it. In fact, I could just go ahead and put this end on now. I just wanna make sure that this fitting is gonna work in here, which I know it will, but I suppose it never hurts to totally make sure it works fine. Just to cover my butt. Never want to go through all the trouble bending a line without forgetting to put the fitting on. Eastwood flare tool. You've seen it before. It's mounted in the vise, ready to go. Link in the description for stuff. This guy, which is the other on the car version of this tool, came with this cool dye lubricant that I'm going to use instead of anti-seize this time. This makes awesome flares. It really, really does. Oh, better. Now that is the proper flare. So it's ready. And I'm just gonna go for it here. Looks like it has a slight bend, just like this, right from the start. Maybe another slight one there. Now I've got to sort of guesstimate because I don't want to bend that yet. Make sure this fits in here. It does. But I just have to sort of guesstimate how much I'm going to be going over. So I'll bend it here and then I'll get a bend there. Then it needs to come over that much more. So I'm going to cut it right there. I'm just gonna take a little file to this since I just freshly cut it. Just clean it up a little bit. Sweet. Now we just gotta bend that over so that it fits. These shorter bends are so much trickier. I know roughly where it's gotta go. I'm gonna bend the line around it on better leverage. Wait, definitely want you up on that side. Too long. Done. Now we will clean up the other side. I'm gonna have to straighten out this bend so that I can flare it. As long as I can get the fitting over, it'll be okay. Let me play with this for a little bit, I'll be back. Not quite long enough yet. So, gotta get a little bendy with it. Trying to get it so that this fits down far enough so that I can get it up into the tool, and I'm not quite there yet. I've actually found my vise to be a really good straightener. Not putting a whole lot of pressure on it, just using it for leverage. That might be enough. And it is. See, I just needed to get it to where it go down through the tool so that when I do the end, I can. Time for Brillo pads. Excuse me while I whack my line. Super cool how easy this cleans up. But it really didn't take me that long to bend the other line. But I'm glad I'm showing both methods here in this video today so that you can make a choice. As far as what you want to do with your vehicle. You don't have all the tools to bend and flare brake lines? Well, you're going to need the flaring part. There's no way around that. I'll obviously put links in the description for you for stuff. But yeah, this is actually the contrast between this and this is quite stark. I'm just going to bend another line. I've showed you two methods. You can take the old lines, clean them up, bend them, flare them, whatever. This looks so pretty and brand new. I still have other line here in my hand, and it really didn't take me that long to bend it up. I'm gonna bend it up a new line. But I'm keeping these around for spares for later. How's that? Just in case. We gotta have our fittings, which I've got both of here. I'm going to remount my flare tool in the vise. Gonna start the inside again, just like I did before. Don't forget the fitting. Did I mention not to forget the fitting? Just gonna clean up the end a little bit, this time using crocus cloth. And I'm gonna use just a little more new lubricant. Up one, up two. Up one, up two. This thing's so efficient, it's like you didn't do anything. I literally feel like I didn't do anything. And I'm done. Perfect every time. In seconds. Just like I did last time, I'm starting here. See how pretty that looks? Yeah, I wanted it pretty. She deserves pretty. Let's find out where she needs to bend. I use this ear as my guide for where I'm going to start going up. And now we figure out where to cut. Okay, so going over here, it's about that long. Highly scientific form of measurement that I'm using. You're going to be the nicest looking monster on the block. Monsters are just such interesting people. Those of you old enough to remember Bugs Bunny, great. Those of you that aren't, look it up on YouTube. Don't forget the end. Where are you, up one? There you are. Perfect every time. Same drill as before. Don't let me get a big head or nothing, but I think I'm kind of getting good at this. I don't think this really needs anything back here as far as retention. In fact, it just being a little bit away from the housing, I think is a good thing. Just having that little air gap there. That way it's not resting up against it. Debris, whatever, can go down in between there. I'm gonna do the same, make sure the same is on the other side, but this diff be ready to install. Yes! We now have new brake lines run on here. Now, I did show you a couple of different options. I mean, this cleaning with Brillo pads worked out super good. And if you wanted to reuse the lines, you could do that. But I decided to go all new. I'm glad I decided to go all new, but I'm also glad that I showed you an alternative that can possibly save you some money. Given the amount of time it took me to bend this and the amount of time it took me to clean it, 6 of 1, half dozen of the other. It's kind of just a question of whether or not you want to use new materials. And if you're building a race car, I say new materials. That's just me. Anyhow, links in the description to everything that's important, tools I use, stuff like that, and whatever else. Automotive questions, if you have those, air@thecarguide.com. Put a link to that in the description as well. Google Plus, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Also links in the description. Be safe, have fun, stay dirty. Thank you so much for watching. It was fun. Your girlfriend's not here. Go. Go on. Go on. Your girlfriend's not here. Your girlfriend's not here. Keep going. You can fly. I know you can fly. You're really committed to that. Oh, you were filming the whole time. We love you, Canada.